coming face to face with Ita can be a little intimidating for some people.
God, yes.
Is that fair, Ita?
No.
Oh, wait a minute.
It's not fair. I'm not intimidating.
Yes,
I'm not intimidating,
are.
Am I?
Initially, you're a little bit
She's
scary.
Kind of like the queen.
Not to them, I'm not.
I like how Ida says, I'm not intimidating, am I? And everyone goes, oh, no, no, not at all. No, it's okay.
Well, our next guest played her former boss, Kerry Packer, in a TV series. How is he going to cope with the real thing? Please welcome actor Rob Carlton.
Hi, Rob. Hi.
Very well, Joe. How are
Excellent.
You?
Great.
Thank you for joining us. Some of our viewers will obviously be very familiar with your work as Kerry Packer on Paper Giants.
And you're incredible in that
you
role.
You were incredible. Oh, we're going to take a look, actually, at you sparring with Asha Keddie as Ita on screen. Have a look at this.
Ita, take a seat. Best chance for this country, but look at him. He looks like a Volkswagen with the doors open.
Yes, I've heard that one.
Whitlam will kill him. It'll be a disaster. You're staying, Ita.
Oh, thanks. I'll go and unpack my bags then.
Rupert got screwed. It's 10 times what he paid for the mirror. If you ask me, the old man should have sold years ago. Never thought I'd see him do it.
Must have been very hard for him.
Anyway, that's got nothing to do with the Cosmopolitan deal. That's still on with Hearst. Now, you gonna need staff. Pick whoever you want. They stay. This is all still on the QT.
Oh. How
do you feel, Ida, watching that? Watching someone being you?
Well, it really just takes you back to when it all happened, you know, that... I mean, I did get a call after Sir Frank sold the newspapers to Rupert Murdoch. I didn't get a one-to-one, but I got a call from Kerry saying, you haven't been sold. Pick the staff for the new project, which was the new magazine, which ultimately became Clio, and so I did. But it just takes you back to what it was like. It's a funny thing. It's a strange feeling when newspapers are sold and a building empties of all its staff, and they all went down to News Limited, and there were only a few of us rattling around in this building that once housed hundreds of people, and suddenly it's cold and there's no noise, and newspapers are very vibrant places, and the phones stopped ringing. That was the most incredible thing. The phones just stopped ringing. There was such a silence.
How did you think Rob went playing the
big
man?
I thought he was terrific, but you did a lot of homework, didn't you? Because we had a session. You know, I know you met with lots of people. You talked with me about how Kerry... I think you asked me, how did his eyes narrow? And I said, well, I don't know what I'm trying to do narrow.
Well, I was playing to my strengths.
Yeah. and I think you saw Malcolm Turnbull. You saw lots of people that worked with Kerry and did a lot of homework. That's why your portrayal was so good.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, of course, terror was the motivating factor for a lot of that. I found out I was going to play the role and I knew everybody would have an opinion.
Did you feel like Kerry would come back from the grave and start yelling at you if you got it wrong?
I'm not a superstitious man, Joe, no. but I tell you what, there would have been a few of his friends that would have come out and said a few things. So to that end, like you do when you're frightened, you work really hard and you do what you can to honour it. Mm. And then you throw the dice and hope for the best. In that way, we were very lucky to have Ita with us and she was an amazing presence in and around the set. And, of course, Asha Keddie, with that landmark performance was something she inspired us all to turn up every day and give it our best.
I was there. It was an absolute blockbuster performance, and I was there. And obviously, then for the follow-up one, they stupidly gave the role of Kerry to someone else. And then just after that announcement, I was there at the Logies, and you took home the Logie for best performance, most outstanding performance for Kerry Packer. You must have felt when you got up on the stage then and goes, sucked in.
Well, I think that's the difference between you and I, Joe.
what did you think of Lockie Hume's performance? Was good as well. Did you?
Lockie's
performance. Was it awkward? Did you stand next to each other at the urinal at the Logies?
Oh, look, obviously we made a date for the urinals.
Lockie's
a close friend of mine. Mm. And, you know, I think we can all agree Lockie's performance was stunning.
Yeah.
And I think if you saw Power Games with his performance as Sir Frank, again, stunning.
He was uncanny. He was very uncanny at Sir Frank. He really did look like Sir Frank. I couldn't believe it.
He's quite something.
Well, no.
And look, I've worked with Lockie, and Lockie came. I produced a show called Shand on Pictures, and I was lucky enough to get Lockie. Yeah. Lockie is fun. Thanks, Donna.
Yeah. You had a generous
and again,
heart.
Well, let me tell you, Lockie turns up.
Yeah.
And he's passionate. And he turns up prepared, and he's got a position, and he's got an opinion. And I know all the work that you've done over the years, the people you would value in your stable are the ones that turn up not looking to you for answers, but with their own sense of what should be.
Absolutely.
And that's the fun stuff to work with, and Lockie brings that every time. So I've only got full respect for
him.
Yeah. Rob, you were actually involved in hosting the actor nominations. Can you tell us a little bit about that? What are your thoughts on some of the nominees?
Oh, well, yeah, so the announcements for the actor nominations occurred yesterday.
Mm-hmm. Which is ACCTA, not actors.
That's right, yeah. Although, of course, every actor thinks, oh, they've named it after us. But that's how we roll.
It's cinema and television awards.
That's right. Yeah. So it's the Australian Academy of Cinema and Television Arts. So we it was all announced yesterday for the big ceremonies coming up January 30th and January 28th. So all the feature films were recognised. There's some big announcements. So The Great Gatsby, Baz Luhrmann's amazing film, got a nomination.
Beautiful movie.
As well as other great films that Australians may not be aware of so much, which is Mystery Road, a fantastic Australian Western. Dead Europe, another one. The Turning, which is a fantastic... Mm. This is a new sort of film that people might be interested in. It's based on Tim Winton's book of short stories, and they've got a whole range of different Australian directors and ensemble casts, and they also picked up a couple of acting nominations as well, Hugo Weaving and Rose Byrne. So, really fun. Hugely diverse group of stories being nominated, and I think that's where the strength of our film industry lies. We've got the capacity to tell big international stories with international stars, with, you know, people like Baz Luhrmann working really hard.
I'm glad his film got nominated because he cops a lot of flack from critics who always sling off at his movies, and then they perform, and this one has performed particularly well at the box office, and it's I liken him to the way the critics treat David Williamson, who I think is one of the great contemporary playwrights. You know, he writes about now really well, and David Williamson cops it from the critics as well. And you think, why don't we keep knocking our own talent in Australia so much?
Yeah, look, it's a great point.
Yeah, we're really proud of.
It is a great point. You know, obviously, while you know, it is great for the up and coming directors to get a light shone on them, I think people forget with Baz, with these amazingly successful people, we suddenly think that everything's easy for them. Baz just gets it. What we've got to remember is that at no point is it easy for anybody to raise that sort of money and to achieve that massive vision. Mm. I assure you, Baz would wake up earlier and go to bed later than most people we know. And every minute of the day, he would be working very hard to achieve the very best he can. Mm. And at no point does anybody at that end of town roll over and say whatever you want. He'd have to fight for everything tooth and nail.
Great Aussie work ethic.
And this is the thing.
Yeah. We have to say goodbye to you. We've run out of time,
what?
Rob.
No. He's a Logie winner. You can't just say goodbye.
Oh, thanks, Joe.
You'll have to come back and be a fifth panellist. We'd love to have more time.
Well, that's lovely of you. Thanks so much for having me.
And I think we are televised in the Actor Awards on Channel 10.
Absolutely. This is a great partnership, and we certainly, everyone, I'm a proud member of the Australian Academy, and we certainly appreciate the support. And Channel 10 stepped up. It's going to be on 8:30 on January the 30th. So we thank everyone here.
Great.